Today we are going to start new topic in physics class 12, that is electric potential. Electric potential is the concept related to electric field only. So if you have understood the concept of electric field, it will be very easy for you to understand the concept of electric potential. Suppose any charge Q is there, Q is source charge. Due to this charge, the electric field is produced around it. If any charge is there, it produces some region up to which it has influence. That is known as its electric field. Suppose this point B, C, A, all are inside the electric field of source charge Q. The distance of point B from Q is R1, is R. R is distance of B from Q. Now, suppose at point B, the magnitude of electric field due to source charge Q is E. At point B, the magnitude of electric field due to this source charge Q is E. Now, all of you know that if any test charge is here at this point Q, suppose test charge is Q naught, then what is the force experienced by this Q naught? That is equal to Q naught E. In which direction? In right direction. This is Q naught E at point C. You can see, at point B. Now, if we want to move this test charge Q naught inside the electric field of Q without acceleration. Why without acceleration? Because we want to measure actually the potential energy of in the test charge Q naught inside the electric field of Q. So for measuring the potential energy, you have to eliminate the kinetic energy term. So if you are moving this charge with some acceleration, so if you are moving the charge with acceleration, means velocity is changing. And all of you have read the work energy theorem. If there is change in kinetic energy, then work is done. So that work done is stored in the form of kinetic energy. Here. So if you are moving that test charge with acceleration, then you are measuring both the potential energy because of the position in the electric field and also the kinetic energy. But here we want to measure only the potential energy. So you have to move without acceleration. So for moving this charge Q naught without acceleration, you all know the net force must be zero. Net force must be zero means you have to apply the force Q naught E in the opposite direction. I think it is clear that we have to move Q naught in the electric field of Q without acceleration, then the force experienced by Q naught due to electric field is Q naught E in this direction. So we have to apply force Q naught E in the opposite direction, means against the electric field. So what is the small work done by us? Small work done by us in moving the test charge Q naught from B to C. First we will calculate for very small displacement from B to C, and we have considered that the distance from B to C is very small, that is equal to dr. So what is the formula for work done? Work done is force into displacement. This force due to electric field is Q naught E in this direction. So the force applied by us in this direction will be minus Q naught E. So this is the force applied by us in the opposite direction, and what is the displacement? Dr. So what is this dw? Dw is small work done by us against the electric field. Against the electric field without acceleration. Now, if I am moving the charge from B to A, we are moving the charge from B to A. So, what is the total work done? You have to integrate. We have to integrate this term from B to A. So, if I am going, if first I will integrate, then I will put the limit. Minus Q naught is common, E is due to source charge Q. What is the electric field? 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by what is the distance of B from C? We have considered to be R. R square dr. So take out the common. Integrate 1 by R square dr. So all of you know this integration. That is minus 1 by R. R to the power minus 2, if you have to integrate, add 1 and divide it by the change of power. That is R to the power 1 by minus 1. That is minus 1 by R from B to A. Now, this is the formula. If you will put minus minus plus, then it is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q naught 1 by R. We have not put the limit now. So we are calculating the formula for work done from B to A. This is the most general form, and from this general form you can define electric potential energy, electric potential, all the things on the basis of this limit and the test charge. First, we are going to define electric potential energy. Electric potential energy. For electric potential energy, we are calculating the work done from infinity to the given point. This B point shifts to infinity where there is no electric field effect. Then we start to enter inside the electric field. If B is at infinity, then this limit will be infinity. And A is at distance, suppose R1 or R2 or anything. So 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q naught 1 by R. We are moving the test charge from infinity to the given point, suppose R. So what will the formula? 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q naught, first put R, so this is 1 by R minus 1 by infinity. 1 by infinity is 0, so this is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q naught by R. That is work done from infinity to A. So if someone asks you, write the definition of electric potential energy. So how will you write? This is electric potential energy is the work done to move a charge Q naught from infinity to the given point without acceleration in the electric field. Now, if someone asks, how will you define the electric potential energy difference? So you have to put here the limit, work done from B to A. Now, this B point this b point is not taken to be infinity, this point b point is suppose at distance r1 and this a point is suppose at distance r2. So you have to integrate the same thing from distance b point is at distance r1 and this is r2. So this work done will be equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q q naught by first you put r2 then r1. We have defined the general formula 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q q naught by r, that is work done and that is equal to potential energy of any test charge. So this is potential energy. If you will write this like this, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q q naught by r2 minus 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q q2 by q q naught by r1. This is potential energy formula at point r2. At point r2 means at point B. So this is potential energy at point B and this is potential energy at point A. So potential energy difference means the work done to move the test charge from a given point to another point inside the electric field without acceleration. So this is the second formula, that is potential energy difference. Now third, electric potential. If you divide the work done from infinity to A, you can see equation 1, this is suppose equation 2. If you will divide this or you bring this q naught in this side, then this formula is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r. This is work done per unit test charge. Work done per unit test charge. To move q naught charge, this work is done. To move unit charge, this work is done. Clear? So try to understand. To move q naught charge, work done is this much. To move unit positive charge, work done is this much. And formula is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q is source charge divided by the distance at which we have to define this point. So this is known as potential. Potential at a given point. How we will define the electric potential at a given point? The work done to move unit positive charge from infinity to the given point without acceleration against the electric field. So this is work done to move unit positive charge from infinity to the given point without acceleration. Without acceleration in the electric field. In the electric field of source charge. So no need to write all the things. So student, you can see that first we have derived the formula, general formula for work done from any given point in the electric field to another point. This is the general formula. Now we have defined the same thing. What is the work done when one point B shift to infinity? The work done is this much. This work done is known as, this work done to move the test charge Q naught from infinity to A is known as potential energy. When you are taking this test charge as unit positive charge, then the work done per unit test charge, that is work done to move unit positive charge, you will get this formula. This is known as electric potential. So this is the very easiest way to understand the thing that how we differentiate between electric potential and electric potential energy. One more thing is left, that is electric potential difference. Now, if I am writing that work done by test charge, if this equation number, suppose this is equation 1, 2, I am writing this equation, work done from point B to A is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q q naught 1 by r. Suppose I have started from r2 to r1, you bring this q naught in this side, okay, leave this. So electric potential difference we have read. Electric potential is the amount of work done per unit test charge, is known as electric potential at the given point. Suppose this is test charge and I am moving at point A. Suppose I have brought any test unit positive charge must be there when we are defining electric potential. Suppose the potential is VA at point A. Again I am bringing this test charge, I have done work, that is equal to work done is equal to VB. So what is the electric potential difference? VB minus VA. And that electric potential difference, you see, suppose I am bringing the test charge from this point to point A, and A point is at distance r1, and then I brought this charge to point B, this is distance r2. So what is potential at point B, at point VB minus VA? So what is the work done to move unit positive charge from this to A? We have derived the formula, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r1. Now what is the work done to move the unit positive charge from infinity to B? 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r2. So this is the work done from infinity to point A minus work done from infinity to point B. So you can see, if I am writing work done from A to B, so this is VB minus VA. This we have to keep in mind, that work done from A to B for unit positive charge, or for unit positive charge if you are calculating, you have to divide by Q naught, that is equal to VB minus VA. This is very important formula and you have to keep in mind that when you are writing the order B to A, you have to write here A to B. That is electric potential difference. So that's all in this class. We will learn more things, particularly the numericals of Gauss law, maybe in the next class. Thank you.